Hey everybody, Sexy Matt the Pharaoh Wizard here with Luna once again. Welcome to another episode of Raiders of the Lost Comic Movie. So Luna's back again. She was so happy she got to watch Spider-Man Strikes Back that she...
Oh, yeah! Oh man, that movie, it's excellent and you should see it.
Definitely. So, are you excited for the new Birds of Prey movie starring the future Mrs. Pharaoh Wizard, Margot Robbie? One they should be scared of. Not you, not Mr. J,
because I'm Harley freaking Quinn. Do you want me to answer that honestly? I'm excited to see what it will be. Okay, I have to say that I am interested in the concept, right? It's fair enough that I'd be like, oh, okay, yeah, this seems like a movie worth seeing. Mm. And then I saw the trailer, and then I was like, but why though?
Oh no, why?
Yeah. Like, this was such a great premise. What happened? So,
they wanted to go with the Suicide Squad aesthetic because Suicide Squad works so well.
Yeah. God. That, yeah, I don't know. I mean, after seeing the trailer, I was just like, all right. I'll see it.
So did you know in 2002, they attempted Birds of Prey already once before?
I had no idea prior to meeting you, Matt.
And that's what we're talking about today, 2002's Birds of Prey. Quick history behind it. It was on the WB in 2002 and somehow got an entire season. So that's a thing. So let's start with what's your initial thoughts on this movie, this pilot?
So it's a show.
It exists.
So my very first thought was like, oh, the 90s, sort of. it was very clearly still very 90s, and yet I was like, well, it's almost like we could be nostalgic for it, but it wasn't that different. That it wasn't so different that we could be nostalgic about it. So it's just like, oh yeah, shows used to be like that.
Yeah. Well, it's not only just 90s, it's very specifically 1999.
It
was the Matrix.
Oh yeah.
Like even with all the the techno background during the fights and stuff, like it was the Matrix.
It really was. And like, oh boy, the score in general, like for the entire, all 47 minutes of it, I was just like, why are there so many, is that a clarinet?
Although speaking of the music, my favorite part, and I seriously laughed out loud, was the very end when it played the Michelle Branch song. If you want to, I can save you. And I got swept away.
If you want to, I can save you. When it played that, I can't describe the moment. Like, I was like, oh man, like, oh 90s, oh boy, oh, like, you know, as it goes. Yeah. And then that moment happened and I couldn't grab my mouse fast enough to stop it. Like, I'm using the credits roll. I get it. It's
over. You didn't wait for the after credit stinger?
There was an after credit stinger?
There was not, no.
Okay. Because I really didn't. I genuinely stopped it as fast as I could. I was like, I can't go back there.
So, okay, so before I get into everything, because everything I'm coming at this is from a comic book standpoint, you don't really know anything about the Birds of Prey in the comics or most of these characters.
No.
So what'd you think of, we'll start with Huntress. That was the main fighting girl with the trench coat.
Yes, and the modified cat, like, roaring sound.
Yes.
I was hoping you'd say something like that.
Every time she had to scream. And I was like, are they going to change it up? Is it going to be different every time? No, it's the same exact one.
They paid for the one sample, and they're going to get their damn money's worth.
So that's what I thought about that character. Well, I mean, I thought it was a cool, like, you know, not coming from a comic book world, I was like, oh, all right, like, that's kind of a cool thing, like, you know, Batman, Catwoman. Kid, she's badass, like, all right. Of course, not having a background, I watched it and I was like, that's not real. And that's who I know it was.
It was kind of interesting though that she was the daughter of Batman and Catwoman, and definitely like the Batman Returns Batman and Catwoman, because you see a quick shot and it's definitely like the costumes they stole from the Warner Brothers back lot and threw somebody in.
Yeah, definitely.
So I thought that was interesting, but from a comic standpoint, literally everything about that character is wrong from the comics.
Oh, okay. So there is a real person in the comics, but it's not that character.
Right. There is a Huntress who is part of the Birds of Prey, but she is the daughter of a mob boss and decided to turn against him and become the Huntress. So she has nothing to do with Batman per se.
Okay, all right.
And actually, she's on your favorite show ever, Arrow. She's in the first season of Arrow. They had a Huntress.
Please. Just don't hurt me.
Nah. How about just a little?
Oh yeah, I did watch the first season before I vomited in my mouth. That's right. Okay. Yeah, I do remember that character. I didn't realize it was supposed, like, I've heard Huntress. I didn't know if it was, you know, whatever.
Yeah. So yeah, her dad was a mob boss and she turned against him.
Okay.
And she'll be played by Mary Elizabeth Winstead in the movie coming up. That's who she's playing. But no, she doesn't have powers. She just has a crossbow.
Okay.
And she didn't have a crossbow in this show. And she has superpowers, so.
Yeah, very different, it sounds.
Which is weird, because they gave her cat powers because her mom's Catwoman, but Catwoman doesn't have powers either.
I had a couple questions. But I was just like, you know what? Like, if we're doing this, I guess I'm here. I guess I'm in it.
Right. Are you in yet?
Of course. Are you sure he's here?
He ordered pizza on his credit card 40 minutes ago.
Once again, Big Sister's watching.
Right?
Well, what's your question on that?
Well, just, like, I didn't quite, I didn't really understand why she was the way she was. Like, as a character, why she had the power she had, it's just like, okay. So she's a badass, and maybe Batman, well, maybe Catwoman, when she was pregnant, had some, like, rolled around in a field full of, like, cancer-giving stuff.
Mayor West, you have lymphoma.
Oh, my.
Probably from rolling around in that toxic waste.
I see.
What in God's name were you trying to prove?
I was trying to gain superpowers.
Well, that's just silly.
Silly, yes. Idiotic, yes.
And
I thought you were going to say roll around in a litter box.
Radioactive cat. And all of a sudden, boom, powers to the baby. But I don't know. I didn't have any frame of reference, but I just accepted that she was very powerful.
And why didn't she have a mask? Like, she works at this very public bar and then beats up people behind said bar. I'm pretty sure people can link those two. Like, I don't know who that is.
No, have you met men? I feel like if you, like, if you're, you know, working at a bar and you have your, like, look that you have, and then you leave that bar and wear a completely different look, guys are like, she's cute. Not knowing that you've been talking to that person for 5 years. Like, it's, I buy it.
I suppose. I think she needed a mask of some, like, the costume was pretty bad. But at least a mask would have helped.
Like, I definitely could have made that costume, like, in my closet, drawn 5 a.m.
I love the little shawl she had for it, too. The little, like, in case it gets a little cold.
But only in this area.
Yeah, only this area, because you still got to be sexy and matrixy.
And everybody has to talk like this. Like, I was like, what?
Well, this is a super serious TV show.
Oh, man.
We're dark.
But to be fair, like, to, you know, looking at it, I was like, okay, I see why we are where we are with CW and all that stuff. Like,
yeah, I was going to say, this is very much a proto Arrowverse show. Yeah, so, like, there's the computer, there's, like, the person in the chair, as they would say in Spider-Man, who's given all the, you know, doing all the hacking. And
clackety clack.
Yeah. And they always have an earpiece in no matter what, so they can talk to them. Like, it felt very much like Arrow got a lot of ideas from this.
Yeah, you'd know better than me, right? Like,
well, even all the Arrowverse, because even the Flash is a little bit like that too.
Oh, for sure,
his team. But this
Supergirl is too.
Yeah, everyone's got the guy in the chair.
Yeah, it was less like the format of how they fight crime and more the way they act. Like, the acting specifically was like, this is how we act when we're in a comic book world, and that hasn't changed apparently.
Yeah.
It's been almost 20 years and we still have people going like this. I'm going to get you. I'm so evil. I'm Harley Quinn. Like, come on. Like, can you be like any other type of villain? But it's for better or worse, it's consistent.
It is. Speaking of the guy in the chair, what'd you think of Oracle, the lady in the chair?
Yeah, I thought that was actually probably the most interesting character of all of them.
No, I agree. Like, I have a good and bad little list going here. I was taking notes. The actress that played her was really good. And
yeah, I really appreciated her. Like, you know, when she was on screen, when she was doing stuff, I mean, the writing was not. But her delivery and, like, just her role, you know, I could see where they were going with that or where they potentially went with that I'm never going to see. But, like, as far as her actual character, she's aight.
Yeah. And she had a pretty good Batgirl costume when we saw it in a few flashbacks. I thought that worked pretty well.
You would know that.
My one problem with her, though, but it's not really with her as much as ever since pretty much the late 90s, the only time we use Batgirl is just so she can get shot by the Joker and we can do the killing joke. And she's sort of like a woman in the refrigerator sort of moment.
I mean, I get it. I support you in your feelings. I know that Batgirl's your fave. Like, you know, I'm like, oh, there was a Batgirl? Cool.
They wasted a good costume too. Like, she could have just been Batgirl. Why'd they have to do Oracle, man?
Yeah, well, we had to see the Joker, who
we did.
By the way, looked. I mean, that flock of seagulls' hair was out of hand. They showed a clip. They keep showing that same clip of the Joker, yep. And just like face and the hair is like, whew, it was so fabulous. Like,
it's a weird take on the Joker. Well, that's how you know he's evil. Is remember in that time frame, all the really put together, nice looking guys.
That's true. Yeah.
Like the mayor of Injian in the Matrix.
Yeah. Maybe. No, you're right. But his hair was.
But did you notice the few times he talked, who did his voice? Because it wasn't the actor that did the voice.
No, who was it?
It was Mark Hamill. He actually came in and did the Joker.
It felt so much at home that I didn't even know. That's so cool. Of course he would do that. Like,
yeah.
Of course. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Batgirl. Past tense. You kill Captain Clown.
Let's see. Okay, so we have one more character, and that's they never call her this, but it's Black Canary, and that's a little blonde girl.
Yep.
I can tell you that's your favorite character from this show.
Not my favorite character. I haven't been able to put my finger on what about her kind of drives me crazy. I think it's that, like, dudes wrote her. Have this whole, like, you know, this is going to be Birds of Prey. We have this really intelligent woman leading this whole thing as Oracle. We have this Huntress girl who's badass, like, also superpowers, I guess. Also very good at martial arts, I guess. Like, so... like, there's definitely that very 90s, but definitely still an effort to be, like, a woman powerful group. And then there's Dinah, and she's just like, I'm a girl. Okay. I'm gonna be, like, clueless. Like, I just...
Fiery tail rising from the ashes, that kind of phoenix?
Yeah, I know they're not real. Phoenixes aren't real, are they?
it just feels like they... Oh
yeah, she was horrible.
I can't with her, and like her whole, well, even that first scene, oh, that was my, I think it might have been my first eye roll. There were many, but like that one scene, like at the beginning when she's, you know, heading to New Gotham, and you know, me not being as comic book nerd was like, what happened to the old one? But
I got things on that. We'll get back to that.
Okay, great. So we she's headed to New Gotham, and this dude's all like, you gotta take care of yourself. And she's like, what?
Although that dude is the best part of her, because did you realize who the dude was? That was Jesse Pinkman.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Aww.
It was his baby Aaron Paul. They made him a rapist.
Yes, science!
Oh, shoot. I didn't realize that.
I had to stop and like, that's Aaron Paul.
I didn't recognize him at all.
So yeah, Black Canary has superpowers in the comics, but she's not an empath. She has a sonic scream. Hence, you know, Canary.
Right.
Why did they make her an empath?
Women are sensitive, and, you know, they can really look into your soul.
The only reason I could think of is just so that the plot could happen and they could give her something to do.
I guess. Yeah. So she's a metahuman.
Yeah, she's got like telepath powers and she can see when people die or when they it was weird.
It's not just you. I was like sitting here like, is there like a clear pattern here? No. Okay,
cool. So what was the bad guy and what was his motivation? Do you know? Because I don't know.
Surely, like, I had missed something big. I even Wikipedia'd it, because that's how far I like to, you know. If I can't text you, I Wikipedia. And so I went to Wikipedia. Wikipedia, and I was like, okay, well, I'll just listen. I'll read the, like, episode description to see if, like, I'll get a name or something on, like, what's going on. And it was just, like, to fight the forces of evil.
Yeah, like, yeah. What?
So who?
I don't know.
Hit something? Like,
although they did hint at a very high-profile villain, if you noticed.
Yeah, I did note that, but I just...
I don't know what the point of this episode was besides, like, introduce everyone and give everyone a reason to do the thing.
Yeah, and, like, you're you know, good guy cop guy.
Oh, yeah.
Undoubtedly going to get caught and trapped at least once in the next season. Like,
so. Oh, yeah.
Like, yeah, but at least he believes in myths or whatever. Yeah.
There's something going on in the city after the sun goes down. I intend to find out what it is.
They made a point to point that out, so.
They did. He believes. All right, so spoiler for this 20-year-old show. Harley is in it.
Oh, yeah.
Did you pick up on the Harley hint?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I mentioned it earlier. Didn't know I was supposed to spoil it.
No, it's so I haven't gone further into the show, but I've seen pictures, and she does get a quasi Harley costume. And what I mean is she has a super scoop neck red sweater that has black diamonds over her boobs.
Hey. Let me just say this. I know I'm coming at this from, you know, today's viewpoint and all this stuff, but have you seen the most recent Harley? Hey. They can do whatever they want.
Margot Robbie is an American treasure, even though she's not an American, so she can do what she wants.
What I do want to say about this Harley in this, like, 90s-tastic, yeah, again, the writing is terrible. The acting is not the best, right? But I did appreciate that, like, her doctor side and her Harley side were, like, delineated, and she was able to go from one to the other in a way that was believable. And it wasn't, like, overly anything. It was quite mundane.
Yeah. No, they
could. I was kind of like, all right, I can take mundane.
they could build up to something for sure. Like, that's another part where it felt like Arrowverse, because remember Arrowverse, every season of any show, like, slightly introduces the villain.
Yeah.
And then it would build it up. So I think this is kind of doing that, where it's like,
I definitely got that sense.
Like, yeah. Here's Harley. She's going to do a thing in next season that we won't get.
Yeah.
They needed those dockyards, Larry. I had a dream. The new Gotham. And people writhing in pain, dying on the streets, and everything under my command. You ruined my dream, Larry!
I mean, maybe she did more. I don't know. I'm not going to watch any more of this. But
I'm not even going to read the Wikipedia episode summaries. I was just like, oh, so there's one season. Cool.
So, why was it New Gotham?
My name is Alfred Pennyworth, and I have a story to tell. For many years in the city of New Gotham, a secret war raged by night.
I had that question for you.
So. I don't know. What? Yeah, exactly what you said earlier. What was wrong with old Gotham?
Like, what happened to it?
What point does that serve the story at all to make it New Gotham, besides...
Like, did everybody move from old Gotham to New Gotham? Or is New Gotham, like, Lodo or Soda Sopa or, like,
Was this, like, a really bad rebranding of the city? Like, yeah. Gotham's all full of crime, but this is New Gotham.
It's the gentrification of Gotham.
Like, we still got the crime, but it's new crime.
It's new, and there are rats. Yeah, I don't know. I truly, like, I was like, oh, I'm gonna need to ask Matt about that, because I didn't get any sense why it couldn't have been Gotham.
What I kept coming back to this show over and over again is just the word why.
But why though?
But why? Why is it New Gotham? Why is Huntress the daughter of Batman and Catwoman?
Why
is business suit man business suiting?
Yes.
Why?
Why is he? Indeed.
Why is the show?
I was like, okay, so we have our business suit guy that is clearly doing this in his tone, right? But then, why?
Why? Yeah, exactly. Why did they make all these weird changes? Why? Like, that's where I came down to. It's like, why is this show?
Yeah.
I don't know.
And that is why it did not get a second season.
Exactly.
I still have a question about Birds of Prey. Why are they called that?
Because
that in the comic?
I don't know exactly, but my assumption has always been because it's generally the Huntress, which is a bird, Black Canary, which is a bird, in Batgirl is a fly thing. I'm assuming it's because
I was like, so Black Canary,
Huntress is a kind of bird, I believe.
Can be, I guess. It's not very clear. I mean, in a world where it's comic books and things are like good, bad, black, white, blah, blah, blah. If it's a bird, it should be a fucking bird.
But I mean,
like, oh, a Galapagos, blue-footed, blah, blah, blah. Like, no, it's a bird. Like, pick a bird name that we all know. There's like hawk people and other bird people. Surely there must be like an eagle or something. Like, come on.
I mean, I'm sure there's a reason, but why are any of the teams named the way they are? The Avengers don't really avenge much.
That's true. Okay, all right, you have a good point.
The Defenders didn't defend crap. They let that whole building crash for the four people that watched Defenders. So I'm assuming it's just a cool name. The writing process behind that.
Yeah, all right, I'll take it.
There may be an in-universe reason. I don't know.
But if there's going to be birds, there should be crows so that there could be murder.
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 Since this was a pilot and it's made to interest you in seeing more of this, did it complete that goal? Do you want to see more?
Of it?
Of Birds of Prey, yeah.
Okay, I will give it this. If I could put it on in the background while I clean my bathroom, do some laundry, and I'm killing time until like a football game or like, you know, a movie that I'm going to, or I'm going out to the goth club, like, then yeah. But am I going to sit down and pay attention to it and learn any of the characters or listen to any of the plot points? Nah. I would treat it like Arrow, which is never intentionally watch it again. But if Netflix happens to, like, I finish a season of something else and it starts playing Arrow and I don't notice, I'm not going to run over and turn it off. I'll turn it off when I get there.
That's fair. I'm quasi-interested to see more just to see, like, what other batshit crazy interpretations of characters they do.
I guess I could see that curiosity. I just can't get over the, like, the 90s acting is a lot to take.
Oh,
and the score. Like, every moment that isn't fighting is like all in the, like, single instruments, couple of instruments, doing whatever they want, vaguely in the same key. Like, I just don't understand. Gosh, it's been a long time. I didn't realize how full scores used to be, where every scene had to have music.
Yeah.
It's not like that anymore, thank goodness. I didn't realize that was a thing.
Yeah, they always had to fill in the noise.
Oh, man, they sure did.
Because if they don't, then you'll pay attention to it.
But no, I just felt like they were like, do you know how you're supposed to feel in this moment? No? Here's a sad for you. Now you know that this is a sad moment.
Although, here's an interesting question. So this came out in 2002. We're not hugely different age difference, but in that time, our age difference would have been, you know, different.
Significant.
So the reason I didn't know this existed, because 2002 is my senior year and I had just a lot going on and I really wasn't watching TV and I actually wasn't even collecting comics yet.
What?
Yeah, it's
there's a map before collecting comics?
There is, yeah.
Yeah.
So that's why I didn't see it.
That's impressive.
Now, I officially started in roughly 06, 07. All right. I watched all the, you know, Batman and all that growing up and all that, but 2002, I wasn't really watching TV or movies that much. So do you remember this at all? Because it wasn't that long ago when we were conscious enough to assume it was going on.
Oh my God, no. 2002, I was 12. So I was in middle school, the worst years of my entire life. Everything I was coming into contact with at that moment was ruining my life, and I believed that wholeheartedly. So at the same time, like, it was during a time when I did have TV on, you know, I was paying attention to, like, shows for teens and stuff like that, and I remember, you know, VH1 and MTV before and after school and, like, horrible TV dramas, but I don't remember this at all on WB, which I feel like I would have been watching.
Right? Yeah. Like, the only time I got any sense that this existed is I was working at Target and I saw the DVD for sale and I was like, what is this? That's the only reason I know it ever even existed. Like, I didn't know it was on TV. Weird.
I have never heard of it, like, ever. But then, so when was Smallville? That's late 2000, like.
Yeah, it was right around the same time. Hold on, I'm curious, because also, like, they weren't doing a whole lot of live-action superhero stuff around this time.
Right, and Smallville was on Fox? ABC Family or Fox Family. I think it was still Fox Family back then or something. I don't remember. Now I'm just saying words.
Now you're just saying things. Let's see.
But I didn't watch Smallville.
2001.
Oh,
when it started. So preceding this, so I guess they probably saw that doing well and decided to do more with it. And this is on the WB as well. So should have seen commercials. You would assume cross promotion.
I watched Smallville like weekly. Like I really liked Smallville, but
man,
I don't remember this at all.
That's just a fail on the marketing department too. Like no one knew this even existed.
They had like one commercial at like 6:07 every night. That's like close to prime time, but.
Yeah, this is weird. This is weird because, yeah, this is only the second of these Raiders episodes where I was, like, alive when it came out. And so it's usually, like, we can laugh at it. Like, we didn't know it existed because it was far gone before we were born.
Right.
But this is, like, right, like, we should have known this existed.
I was in front of the TV watching WB. I should have come across this. I wonder when it aired. Like, I wonder what day, time, like.
I don't know. That'd be interesting to look at. Because, yeah, you'd think, yeah, if it's on during Smallville, they should have had commercials for Birds of Prey. Right, exactly. You like this. Huh. Man, their marketing department sucks.
Yeah, it did. Oh, boy.
So what do you say, Birds of Prey? Is it a lost gem or is it rightly forgotten? I think we already know the answer.
I'm trying to come up with a nice one, but yeah, I think it's a, don't bother.
It's exactly. Yeah. That's, it's really,
bad. I'll tell you what, it's probably about the same quality as the new one coming out.
Oh, I was going to say it's the same quality as the Witchblade show, which I reviewed earlier on this.
Oh. Which
is also around the same time.
Oh, wow. Yeah, no. I'm going to go see the new one. I want it to be, you know, good, but if they use too much CGI, let it looks like they're gonna.
But it's got a hyena in it.
Is it a real one?
I don't know. Probably not, because they're very dangerous.
It looks bad.
But I would say you should watch Birds of Prey if you want to very much appreciate the comic book TV shows we have now. Because, like...
Oh, not the new movie, the old one. Yeah, I definitely agree with that. I will agree with that wholeheartedly. Like, this felt like a history of cinema class, where it's
exactly, like here's our time capsule.
Yeah.
Like, here's where comic books were in 2002. Like, we had Spider-Man, I think, was 02, and we had this. And Smallville, apparently, was also in that time frame.
Right. Like, that's before it dumped all the sharks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, yeah. I think we should end this the same way they ended that show.
No.
If you want to, I can save you.
Yeah.
Hold on, my cat's eating my headphones.
Go, kitty, go.